Good morning, students. Welcome back to class. We are going to continue our GST chapter with the next concept. Already done enter. Now I am going to state intra. Intra, in intra case, we will take two GST half in two parts. Now see, there is a given sum, and one thing more, there is also maybe discount is given. If discount is given, then how to solve it? Now I am taking a long sum because there is a discount is given, then intra case is given, then few quantities are given, then how to solve? Suppose there is MRP for each, page number 7, MRP is given 125, that means the price of the article is 125, that is list price written printed on that product. Then the number of items, I want to take this item, suppose this is a something like a, we can say pen. This is the cost of one pen. Then I want to buy 20 pens. That means quantity is 20. Now I want one cost is 125 and the quantity is 20. Then total cost, what I have to pay? I have to multiply this. The one cost multiplied by the quantity. That means the total cost will be 125 multiplied by 20. When I multiply it, it becomes 2500. Then 125, this become, now this is the cost. Now suppose there is not given discount, I take with discount. Now suppose on this cost there is also given discount, and discount is 10%. Now see students, discount is 10%. Don't take first discount then subtract. That will be tough for you because our paper is lengthy. We have to take according to time. Now if the discount on this particle discount is 10%, then how to find it? I will don't take because 10% discount. What I have to pay? I have to pay 90%. 10 is the discount out of 100. 10 is the discount. I have to pay 90 rupees. If 100, 10 is the discount. Discount means I have not to pay. What I have to pay? I have to pay 90. It means the payment of my, I will take it. You can take it this 10, 100 minus 10. It becomes 90. It means I have to pay 90. Payment of mine will be 2500 multiplied by 90%. That means don't take the discount. Discount, subtract discount from the 100. The left I have to pay and I want the payment. So that's why I take it 90%. If I cut it, then it becomes 0. This one. This is after, the total payment is 2500. After discount, I have to pay 2250 rupees. Now this is the payment, and now I have to see the GST. GST given 12%. Now on this GST is given 12%, but there is condition of intra. If condition of intra, what to do? We have to find the CGST, also SGST. That means 0.5% of this given GST on this value, what I have to pay. First I find the CGST. Now in CGST, total percentage is 12, but I have to find the 6%. That means 6% of this value 2250. Now percentage become 100. Now do the calculation. If I cut it 3, there will be 5, there will be 45, and 45 multiplied by 3, there is 135. It means I have to CGST 135 and SGST also, because same 6% is there. There will be same. It means SGST also 135. Now I have to find IGST. In intra case, IGST will be 0 because half is going to CG, central government, and half will go to S, Janiki, state government. That means I have to full payment of my 2250, that is now after cost, that discount. After the discount, that is cost, I have to pay. Then there is CGST, that is 135. Then there is SGST, that is also 135. Now I can add these numbers, that become the full payment of mine. It means in intra we have to find first half CGST and half SGST, but in case of intra we will find the full fledged GST on the payment. And see students, in these sums just you have to remember two things, one inter and intra. Don't confused about it. Inter, we know that, like that international, that means one nation to other. Same way inter means one state to other, and we have to take the full payment. But in case of intra we will take the half percentage for CGST and half for SGST. And in next exercise is one concept, that is net GST. What is the net GST? See, this is only one place to other place or inside the state. But if the one place to other, then the third one, then the next one, then what to do? Suppose there is a person A, he sell the product to B, then he sell the product to C. Now this A person take the 100 rupees thing and sell it to the B, and GST rate is 10%. Now A will sell it and B will buy it. Now GST percent is 10. B buy, that means B will pay the GST because B is buying, A is selling. Who is taking that product? He have to pay the GST. Now 10% GST, 100 plus 10%, that means 110, and GST is only 10%. Now this B now buy 100 rupees and GST pay 10 rupees. Now he will sell to the C. Now how to see 100 rupees, he increase some value, he buy 100 and pay the GST 10, but he will sell this product to C at 120 rupees. He increase the, because he wants some profit, he increase the value and sell this 100 rupees product in 120 rupees. Now in 120 rupees, if he again GST is 10%, that means 120 10%, that become only 12 rupees. It means the C will pay 120 plus 12, 132. Now B's payment is 110, C's payment is 132, and the GST difference, there's 10 and 12. This GST, that is called debt GST, that means next GST we have to subtract the last GST. That means I want to find 12 minus 10, it become 2. That means the net GST will be 2. Just you have to remember, if one place to other place that will go, if discount is given, there he increase the price, I add 100 plus 20. But if it decrease, that means discount, that will I will subtract the value from this one and go to the forward. And if the price is decrease, that means GST also decrease. And you can solve it. It means you just GST, take a remember that one, that is a interest we have to give, we have to pay. Percentage is given, and according to the percentage we have to just taken the two things, one is inter and other one is intra. If inter we will take the full fledged, if intra we will take the half and half, and we just do the calculation. Only calculation is there, and please doing the, while doing the calculation you have to do it properly. If your in your calculation one digit is wrong, that means you have to, all the calculation will wrong. And one thing more, when you give the answer, then if there is points value, there is given 142.5, don't take this 5, your marks will be deduct, because paisas are not 5, that will be 50. It means after point I have to take a 0 along with the digit, that means 50 paise. Clear students? If you have any doubt you can ask me from your comment, so please try to do it. Okay, thank you students.